Hello and welcome to our how-to video with RFU6xx. Today we show how to set the right size of reading field with the help of transmit power and RSSI threshold. The biggest advantage of UHF RFID is the huge reading field. You can identify tags from 0 millimeters to several meters away without having to manage line of sight, a certain depth of field, or illumination. This great strength is also a potential weakness for UHF RFID. Most RFID applications require a reading zone that is limited to a certain space in front of the reader's antenna. For example, you do not want to read tags from neighboring objects which do not belong to the event. So how do you configure the RFU for the desired reading field? The answer is, find the right values for transmit power and threshold for the received signal strength indicator, or RSSI value. SOBIS-ET includes a helpful tool to find the appropriate settings for transmit power and RSSI threshold. Access SOBIS by selecting the icon on your desktop, connect an RFU6xx, in our case an RFU6xx. Select Single Tag ID Wizard on the device page in the lower left corner. Here you can see the selection of antennas. In our example with RFU6xx, we only have one, the internal antenna. And select Next. Now put an RFID tag in front of the RFU6xx. Place it in a location and orientation that is typical for your application. This tag will be your target tag for use in this wizard. The goal is to have that tag be the only one in your read results. Search for the unique item identifier, or UII, of your target by selecting the Start Scan button. If multiple tags show up, select the right one, line turns blue, and then select Next. This page shows the current values of transmit power and RSSI level. Select Start Scan. On the left side, the red column indicates the minimum transmit power which is necessary to identify the target tag. The right column shows the received signal strength, RSSI, of the target tag. By moving the tag closer to and further away from the RFU6xx, you can observe the values changing immediately. Closer, transmit power will drop and RSSI will increase. Further away, transmit power increases and RSSI drops. By the way, you can use this page to optimize the position of the tag in a specific environment. Try to find the sweet spot where the transmit power is minimum and RSSI maximum, or just to get a rough feeling about the needed transmit power and signal strength. Then select Next. The diagram on this page shows RSSI versus transmit power. Now place additional RFID tags of the same type in the scene at a distance that is further from the antenna than the target tag. By selecting Start Scan, the RFU6xx starts reading tags while the transmit power is increased step by step. The curves display the identified tags with their signal strength as the transmit power from the RFU6xx is increased step by step. The blue color indicates the target tag. Gray lines show tags further away that are also being read. These are commonly referred to as overshoots. The wizard will calculate suggested values for transmission power and RSSI threshold at the end of the scan. These values will be indicated as a cross on the graph and shown as numeric values on the lower right side. To accept the values suggested by the wizard, please select the Apply button next to both transmission power and RSSI threshold. Then select Next. On the last page, select Start Scan to read tags with the settings you just applied. This view verifies the setup. If the settings are correct, only the blue line of the target tag should be seen. A gray line will appear when another tag comes as close to the RFU6xx as the target tag. If you see gray lines from the tags that are further from the RFU6xx than the target tag, or if there's no blue line, select Back. This will take you to the Configure the Device / Set Application Parameters window. Follow the on-screen instructions to either try to have the wizard calculate the values again or to set the values manually. Then select Next to repeat the verification process. If the result is satisfactory, select Finish. Now you can save the new settings permanently to the RFU620. As you just have seen, the single tag ID wizard is the easiest way to adopt the size of reading field for a single tag application. This tool is also available on RFU610, RFU630, and RFU650.